Next, we will look at how the replacement policy for the cache, which chooses, if you remember, which block to kick out when we need more room, interacts with the hit time of the cache. A simple replacement policy, such as random, which randomly picks the block to replace among those that are in the set, has nothing to update on a cache hit. When we have a cache hit, we don't have to do anything in order to be later able to do random. When we have a miss, that's when we start implementing our policy by randomly selecting a block to kick out. This results in faster hits because there is nothing we need to do for the replacement policy when we have a hit. And that's nice. However, the random policy is not very good for miss rate because we often kick out blocks that we will very soon need to use. And we don't like that. In contrast, least recently used, or LRU, results in a lower miss rate, which we like, but we have to, on every cache hit, update potentially a lot of counters. Even if we don't update them, we have to look at them. So there is a lot of activity on every cache hit that results from needing the state that we will later use to select the block we will kick out. And this spends a lot of power and also results in slower hits. To illustrate what happens on a cache hit using LRU, let's look at the four-way set associative cache whose counters are currently 0, 1, 2, and 3. If the processor accesses this line here and has a hit, the new values of the counters are going to be this one becomes the most recently used, and all of the other counters get decremented. As you can see, all of the counters have changed, and this happens on a cache hit. So a cache hit can result in updating up to n counters where n is our associativity. Let's look at what happens when one of the more recently used blocks is accessed. Let's say we access not the most recently used, but the next one. In that case, this becomes the most recently used block. The counters that are larger than this one get decremented, so this becomes 2, and the smaller than this stay the same. So we get this. So only 2 counters have changed now. But note that even though we have only changed 2 counters, we had to actually check for each counter whether it's lower than this or not. So even when we access the most recently used block and the counters don't change at all, because this becomes 3 and counters larger than it get decremented, but there is nothing larger and this lower than it stay the same, we still had to determine that this is the highest counter anyway, so that we don't decrement anything, or we had to actually check for each of these counters whether it's lower. So one way or the other, even for a hit to the most recently used block, we have to do something. And that, again, slows down the hits and spends power. So what we want is a replacement policy that retains the miss rate very close to LRU, meaning we want to smartly replace the blocks so that we kick out the block that is unlikely to be used soon, or the least likely to be used soon, but we want to do less activity on cache hits to do that.